Ariela currently works at the Center for Bioinformatics Simulation and Modeling, CBSM, at the Universidad de Talca. Her research area is focused on computational structural biology of membrane proteins, and she's particularly interested in revealing the structural basis of protein-protein interactions regulating the function of ion channels and membrane transporters. Thanks, Ariela, for being here, and please go ahead with your talk.
Thank you, Lucia, for the introduction. Are you seeing my screen?
I think you need to share now because we're having the general screen for speakers.
Okay. So now it's okay?
Yes, now it's okay.
Okay. Thank you, Lucia, for the introduction, and thanks to the organizers for inviting me to participate of this online meeting. And today I'm going to talk about protein-protein interaction regulating the function of membrane proteins. So protein-protein interactions have shown to be key regulators of the physiological function and subcellular localization of membrane proteins, for example, ion channels and membrane transporter. And in our group, we are interested in describing the functional relationships between different macrocomplexes through the mapping of protein-protein physical contacts. So here, for example, we have protein 1 associated with protein 2. So we want to describe at the molecular level the electrostatic forces, hydrogen bonds, and hydrophobic contacts modulating the formation of this complex in here. At the experimental level, several in vitro techniques have been used to detect protein-protein complexes, but we are more familiar with mass spectrometry-based proteomic data. In fact, to describe protein-protein interactions, we are collaborating with Dr. Oscar Cerda from Universidad de Chile. Dr. Cerda is the director of the Millennium Nucleus of Ion Channel Associated Diseases in Chile, and he provides us mass spectrometry data which have allowed the identification of protein-protein interactions regulating the biophysical properties, trafficking, and membrane stability of TRP channels. So this family of ion channels consists of six subgroups. And today I'm going to talk mostly about this grouping here, called the TRPC canonical channels. And this protein have six putative transmembrane segments with a pore region in here. And the cytoplasmic portion have different functional and structural domains. And this kind of ion channels can form homotetramers and heterotetramers, as you can see in this figure in here. So taking into account mass spectrometry-based proteomic data, we design an online platform called PPIMass for the post-processing of mass spectrometry data and the identification of protein-protein interactions involved in ion channel-associated diseases. Our platform offers a computational pipeline to differentiate a set of proteins, employing analysis of properties such as function, sequence length, availability of 3D structure, subcellular location, and associated pathologies in order to identify key proteins interacting with specific ion channels. So here, as an example, we analyzed more than 1,000 proteins associated with the TRPC6 ion channel, and employing different filters, we found the protein BAPA as a putative candidate to interact with the TRPC6 channel. In addition, based on previous report of BAPA interacting with other proteins, we propose BAPA as a regulator of the expression and trafficking of the TRPC6 to the plasma membrane. So in this regard, this kind of protein-protein interactions can be used as a therapeutical target to treat TRPC6-related diseases. In fact, overexpression of TRPC6 and BAPA has been involved in different pathologies, for example, neurological and cardiac conditions, cancer, and other. So based on that evidence, at this point, we decide to use different computational structural biology methods to describe the sequence and structural determinants of the TRPC channel association with BAPA. So at the beginning of this study, we propose a protein-protein interaction model like this one in here, with a BAPA attached to the membrane of the endoplasmic reticulum and the TRPC6 channel located in the plasma membrane. So to validate this as protein-protein association, immunoprecipitation assays were performed by our collaborator, Dr. Oscar Cerda from Minicat. And this experiment demonstrated physical association between TRPC6 and BAPA. In addition, we found in literature that a FAT motif is required to bind a BAPA. So this protein in here are protein interacting with BAPA, and all of them have this motif in here. So at this point, our question was, if does TRPC6 contain this motif? So first, we did a multiple sequence alignment between proteins known to bind BAPA and the sequence of the TRPCC channel. And it was a surprise for us that this protein also have this FAT-like motif in here located at the cytoplasmic region of the channel. And here, in this part of our research, we didn't have the crystal structure of human BAPA. So we have to generate an homology model based on the structure of rat. But these two proteins are almost identical with 96% of sequence identity. We also refine in here the cryo-EM structure of the TRPC6 channel, adding some missing residues surrounding the FAT-like motif located in this intracellular region of the channel. And to do that, we use different ab initio methods in Rosetta. On the other hand, we perform evolutionary couplings analysis to detect a pair of residues mutating together, which means that this residue can be physically associated. And based on that result, we found interprotein evolutionary couplings surrounding the FAT-like motif in the TRPC6 channel, which supports the association with BAPA. So using this information, we ran protein-protein docking simulation, and using Haddock and Rosetta, we predict a favorite conformation of the TRPC6 and BAPA complex. So here we have BAPA binds to the intracellular region of the channel. Here is only interacting with one subunit because this channel are homotetramers. So using as a starting point the protein-protein docking conformation obtained by docking, we generate a molecular dynamic system with the protein-protein complex embedded into a lipid membrane. We add a water box with an ion concentration, and we run this simulation by 1.2 microseconds using the CHARM force field and the software NAMD. And here we wanted to describe specific residues interacting in the binding region of these two proteins. So according to this contact map calculating during the simulation, we found important residues here in close contact with the residues surrounding the FAT-like motif in the channel. Specifically, we found positively charged residues, it means lysine and arginines in BAPA, interacting with negatively charged residues in the channel. This aspartic and glutamic acid located surrounding the fat leitmotif. And it was very interesting for us that BAPA, rather than interacts directly with the fat leitmotif, this protein form electrostatic contact here with negatively charged residues surrounding the fat leitmotif. So here is the electrostatic potential surface. So then, to corroborate the importance of these residues, we use a protocol including coarse grain simulation and umbrella sampling, and to describe the binding free energy of the protein-protein complex in the presence of the wild-type proteins, and also we evaluate a set of mutation here, specifically mutation in the region surrounding the fat leitmotif. And according to this simulation that we perform with the SIRA force field and the software Gromax, we found that the electrostatic residues surrounding the fat leitmotif are very important to the association between TRPC6 and BAPA. In fact, the most important residues are these two aspartic acid in here. So this is still an ongoing project. So now we are waiting for experimental data to corroborate our prediction. So as a conclusion of this first part of my talk, the PPI mass server is useful for post-processing mass spectrometry proteomic data and allowed us to easily identify protein-protein complexes with pharmacological potential. Also, computational structural biology methods applied in this study provide important insights into the association of the TRPC6 channel and endoplasmic resident BAPA protein. And we identify the presence of a target signal in TRPC6. It means the fat leitmotif, which is conserved in different family of proteins interacting with BAPA. And through evolutionary couplings analysis, protein-protein docking, molecular dynamics simulation, coarse grain, and free energy calculation, we found the cytoplasmic N-terminal region of the channel as the contact area to bind the immunoglobulin-like beta sheet domain of BAPA. And now experimental assays to describe the specific role of BAPA protein as a TRP channel modulator, as well as mutation analysis to validate the predicted TRPCs and BAPA binding region are still required. So in our group, we study different protein-protein interaction. So another example is this one in here, which is the dopamine transporter inhibition mediated by G proteins. So the function of the dopamine transporter can be regulated by different intracellular and extracellular mechanisms, including protein-protein interactions. And recently, it was reported a novel mechanism describing the regulation of the human dopamine transporter by G proteins. So normal function of that involves uptake of dopamine into the neuron, but when this protein is associated with G beta gamma subunit, we observe dopamine efflux, which means neurological and psychiatric disorders. So based on experimental data, the G beta gamma subunit binds to the C-terminal region of the dopamine transporter, but in the crystal structure of this protein, we didn't have the N-terminal and C-terminal fragment. So the first challenge in this project was generate a model of these two regions. And according to secondary structure prediction, the N-terminal fragment adopts a random coil, but the C-terminal regions have a small alpha helical portion. So based on that evidence, we use in here ab initio folding with Rosetta. And we got we got this final model in here with the N-terminal as a random coil and the C-terminal domain with a small alpha helical portion, which agree with previous secondary structure prediction. So we use the full-length dopamine transporter model to generate a molecular assembly of the transporter with G beta gamma subunit employing protein-protein docking simulations. And we use FAIR HADOC, and then we use Rosetta. And here we generate 20,000 docking conformation, and we select the best one or the optimal one by using the RMSD versus Rosetta total score. And according to the best protein-protein complex, we run molecular dynamics simulation. So here is the protein-protein complex with a lipid membrane of POPC. And we add a water box with an ion concentration. And we run in here 500 nanoseconds with three replicas. And we wanted here describe the specific residues interacting in this region. So according to this contact map, we found in this fragment, the C-terminal fragment, these residues in the C-terminal fragment in here, mostly interacting with the G-beta subunit. And these residues agree with previous experimental data where this group, Garcia Olivares et al., did different fragmentation of the C-terminal domain, and they found specifically this region in here interacting mostly with the G-beta gamma subunit. So basically, our computational model agree with previous experimental data. So as a conclusion of this second part, G-beta gamma subunit were previously reported interacting with ion channels, enzymes, and intracellular regulators. However, that is the first neurotransmitter transporter found to be regulated by G-beta gamma subunits. Also, ab initio modeling, protein-protein docking, and molecular dynamic simulations support the association of the dopamine transporter with the G-beta gamma subunits through the carboxy terminus of the transporter acting as the interaction site. And our study is useful for better understanding that regulation mediated by external proteins. So also this study provides molecular basis to treat G-beta gamma subunit associated dysfunction. And it's remained to be seen whether additional plasma membrane transporter of the neurotransmitter sodium symporter family are also modulated by G-beta gamma subunits. This work was recently published in Journal of Chemical Information and Model. So if you want to see more details, you can download the paper. And as I said before, in our lab, we study different protein-protein interactions. For example, here, the potassium channel shaker is interacting with an N-terminal fragment, which can block the pore of the channel. Here, we are also studying the TRPC6 channel interacting with the rotenkin protein. Here, we have other channel, the TRPM4, interacting with this small fragment in here. Also, we are describing TRPC3 with this 14-3-3 eta protein. And now, we want to also describe channel-channel interaction like this example in here with TRPM4 interacting with TRPC1. And in our group, we are mostly focused on study protein-protein interaction in membrane proteins, but we are also describing other protein not located at the membrane, for example, this integrin protein in here. So finally, I would like to thank Oscar Cerda, Horacio Poblete, and Wendy Gonzalez, who present this morning. And they are part of our team to study ion channels in Chile, MINICAT, and people from my lab, Mariela Gonzalez, who did mostly of the platform, the PPIMAS platform. My students, Roberto Rosales, Genoveva Rojas, Nicolás Peña, and Julio Salgado. This is our cluster computer in Talca, Chile. This is part of the people working in our center, Center for Bioinformatics Simulation and Modeling. And I would like to thank Fondesit because they provide me the financial support to do this project and other ones. And finally, thanks to my husband and my two kids, because they helped me to prepare this presentation. And thanks all of you for your attention.
Thank you very much, Ariela. That was a great talk, very interesting. Okay, I will ask, I will lead with one question and then I will go on to some other questions that have been asked. I was curious, for you are studying doing these MD simulations with membrane proteins. And as you showed, some of the intracellular regions of the membrane proteins can be quite disordered and flexible. So what do you think would be the effect, or have you thought of exploring different types of water models or force fields to treat these types of regions in the membrane proteins instead of the force fields that are usually used for folded proteins? How do you approach these issues, or do you think it would be helpful in describing these regions of the membrane receptors?
Thank you for your question. Yeah, of course, the membrane is an important issue in our simulation. As a standard, we use the CHARM force field in MD, and we try to do the bigger membrane as we can. But of course, we can see sometimes some deformation surrounding in the region surrounding the proteins. But we think that in the real system in cells, the membrane can be a little bit can have some diffusions or flexibility surrounding the proteins. But we didn't. We are not studying this kind of association, but I know that it is very important. Maybe we can try to describe this kind of interaction in a future, but not in this study.
Thank you very much. There's one other question. They asked, is the PPI MAS-DB that you used available for use by others?
Oh, no, not yet. We are working, we have a very beta version now, but we are working on that. And I think this is going to be a very useful tool to analyze mass spectrometry data where you have thousands of protein. And if you want to select one specific protein according to some parameters, this platform will be very useful. We hope to finish this platform soon.
Great. Thank you. I guess, well, we have some time. So while I wait to see if there's any other questions, I had another follow-up question on the first project that you presented with the FFAT motif. Yeah. I was curious, you described that you saw some interactions in the flanking residues with the receptor, but I was curious, does that represent an alternative binding mode of this motif, or do you still see the canonical interactions of the FAT motif plus these interactions of the flanks, or do the flanks interact and the motif is binding in a different way?
I think that the FAT-like motif is kind of a structural scaffold in this region, but the most important interaction are with the negatively charged residues surrounding that residues. We are not very sure yet if the FAT-like motif is very essential interacting, but we are pretty sure that this is a kind of a scaffold in this binding pocket.
Great. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. So I think we don't have more questions. So we thank you very much for your talk. That was great.